In this clip, we're going to be talking about how to make observations of mineral cleavage and crystal habit. We're going to talk about these properties together because they're very much related properties. Both cleavage and habit are a reflection of how the atoms are arranged and bonded in our mineral crystal. Samples that grow in certain shapes tend to also break into those same shapes. In other words, when you take a sample and break it on its cleavage directions, you end up with a sample, you end up with a shape that's the same as the sample, as the shape the mineral grows in. So cleavage is recognized by those directions where bonding is weak in the sample. The sample is more easily broken in certain directions than in others, depending on how or where the bonds are weaker in the mineral's crystal structure. We have arranged here on the table mineral samples that were chosen to reflect or to show or to illustrate different cleavages and crystal habits. The easiest type of cleavage to recognize is when you have cleavage in just one direction. A stack of paper is another example of cleavage in one direction. Our stack of paper, regardless of whether we have 10 sheets, 100 sheets, or 1,000 sheets, has a single cleavage direction between those sheets of paper. In other words, each direction with the same orientation counts as one cleavage direction. This is our cleavage direction or cleavage surface. Opposite face, same orientation, same cleavage direction. The sample has a natural tendency to break in that direction. This particular sample has perfect cleavage. It easily breaks in long, thin sheets, reflecting the direction where bonding is weakest in that atom or in that mineral. Perfect cleavage occurs when the cleavage direction is much weaker than other directions in the mineral's crystal structure. So in describing cleavage, cleavage is not a yes or no proposition. If cleavage is observed, you need to also describe the number of cleavage directions. And if there's more than one cleavage direction, you need to include not just the number of directions, but the angles those directions make with respect to each other. An easy type of cleavage to recognize when there's more than one direction is cubic cleavage. A cube has six sides. Each of those sides is parallel to the opposite side. So you can think of a cube as having three cleavage directions, three unique orientations, six faces. But each of those faces is paired, has the exact same orientation in space. This sample, we can see, has many, many small cubes, reflecting both a cubic habit, growth shape, and cubic cleavage. Three directions of cleavage, those cleavage directions intersecting at perpendicular angles, 90 degrees. This sample also has three cleavage directions, but note that the angles of intersection are not perpendicular. They're oblique, an angle other than 90 degrees. This sample has three cleavage directions, not at 90 degrees. We would describe that as rhombic cleavage, a slanted cube formed by three cleavage directions intersecting at angles other than 90 degrees. Three directions, each face, or each direction parallel, counts as one direction. In other words, this is a cleavage direction. This is the same cleavage direction, same orientation. Here's a second cleavage direction. Here and here, parallel. And then we have our third cleavage direction. Different than the other two. So a useful way to think about recognizing cleavage directions would be looking for planar surfaces that are repeated, planar orientations that you see more than once in the sample. He doesn't have to be perfectly smooth. In other words, there's edges here formed by the intersection of other cleavage directions with this cleavage surface. So three cleavages not at 90 degrees, different from three cleavages at 90 degrees. We could have two cleavage directions. And again, we need to think about, are those cleavages at 90 degrees or not 90 degrees? In looking for cleavage surfaces, it's generally the surface that best shows the luster of that sample. In other words, the brightest surface is often a cleavage surface. Here's a cleavage surface. To confirm that that's a cleavage surface, we'd want to see that same orientation repeated elsewhere in the sample. And we do over here. This has the exact same orientation. It's on the opposite side. Similarly bright in luster, one cleavage direction. The second intersects that cleavage, the previously identified cleavage direction, at almost 90 degrees. These little surfaces here, perpendicular to this cleavage direction. Notice how on the end, that cleavage imparts a grain, that cleavage direction is imparting a grain, if you will, to the mineral sample. Two cleavages intersecting at approximately 90 degrees. This is not a cleavage face. It's not planar. Luster is not as bright. That's how we can tell the difference between a cleavage face, a cleavage surface, and just a face of the mineral crystal that's not a cleavage direction. Irregular, and not showing the luster as well. Regular, relatively smooth, showing the luster much better. That's a cleavage direction. This is not. Two cleavage directions may also intersect at an angle other than 90 degrees. This surface is one cleavage direction, again, relatively smooth, showing the luster well. Here's another face, relatively smooth, showing the luster well, a different cleavage direction. Look how they intersect. Look at the angle that those surfaces make. It's an angle other than 90 degrees. It's an angle more like 120. So the cleavage of this sample is described as two cleavage directions, not at 90 degrees. This sample also has cleavage. Notice the grain that those cleavage surfaces impart to the sample. And it's a cleavage similar to the one we started with. One direction, the difference is that this cleavage was excellent or perfect. We could break the mineral into long, thin sheets because the cleavage direction was much weaker than other directions in the mineral crystal. This cleavage is poor. It's much harder to break the sample in that cleavage direction because it's not quite as weak as other directions in the sample. Is it possible to have more than three cleavage directions? It is. It can be harder to find more than three cleavage directions when they exist in a sample. There are some minerals that have as many as six cleavage directions. We tend to think in three dimensions, though, length, width, height, making it somewhat difficult to recognize when more than three cleavage directions are present. How many cleavage directions does this sample have? Here's a cleavage surface. Here's a surface, different orientation. Here is a surface, different orientation. And here's a surface, different orientation. Again, we're looking for the smoother, more lustrous faces as cleavage faces. One, two, three, and four cleavage surfaces, cleavage directions in this sample. By definition, when you have four cleavage directions that can't intersect at 90 degrees, So we have four cleavage directions not at 90 degrees. Minerals that lack a distinct geometric shape often do so because they lack cleavage directions. Such samples are said to be massive. No distinctive shapes, no cleavage directions in the sample. So the absence of cleavage is worth noting as well. No cleavage is present or observed, you write none. The most likely habit for such a mineral would be massive, no distinctive geometric shape.